Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So today again I have taken the topic of class 12, chapter number 7, exercise 7.6. In our previous video we have done question number 1 to 10 related to this exercise. So those who want to see the video, because in that video we have given the introduction of the islet rule or integration by parts. So please follow that video first of all. The description is given in the I link. You can just click over there to get the full understanding of the concept of integration by parts. So proceeding from question number 11, let's see how to solve this question. This is integration of x cos inverse x upon square root of 1 minus x square. So first of all, we have done this question in 9th, 10th question also. I told you that whenever we are having the inverse function, we can remove this function by just substituting the value of x. So here, how can we remove cos inverse x? Just put x is equal to cos theta. So if I will put x is equal to cos theta, then differentiating both sides, I will get dx is equal to minus sine theta d theta. So replacing these values in this integral, see this x becomes cos theta, cos inverse, this x will be cos theta, this dx will be minus sine theta d theta, and in the denominator we get 1 minus cos square theta. Now cos theta into this cos inverse can be cancelled by cos, I get only theta, minus sine theta d theta upon. Now students, 1 minus cos square theta is sine square theta, and the square root of sine square theta is sine theta. So sine theta again cancels. So simple, very simple question it becomes. Now you can see you have done this type of integral many times in the first, second, third part. Same you have done. So just apply islet rule, which state that this function is going to be first function and trigonometric function is going to be second function. So just apply integration by parts now. So integration by parts, what do we get? First function is going to be as it is, the integration of second function minus integration the derivative of first function and the integration of second function d theta whole d theta. So this is the formula to find out the integration by parts. So what do we get? The integration of cos is going to be sine theta minus the derivative of theta with respect to theta becomes 1. The integration of cos theta with respect to theta becomes sine theta d theta. Finally, the integration of sine theta is minus cos theta, and minus minus becomes plus cos theta plus c. So yes, we have found out the integration, but don't forget to just change the value of x. So our question is in the form of x. So here cos theta is equal to x. So that means we have to change everything in the form of cos. So just see here, this sin theta can be written as square root of 1 minus cos square theta plus cos theta plus c. So just now replace. From here you can see that the value of theta is cos inverse x. Substitute the value, we get root 1 minus cos square theta. Cos theta is x, so x square. Then after that I am putting theta. Theta is equal to cos inverse x. Plus cos theta is x. Plus c. So this is the answer. Please note down. So students, question number 12 is integration of x secant square x. Using the rule of islet. So here, the trigonometric function is going to be second function and algebraic function is going to be first function. Integrating by parts, just apply the formula. First function as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function dx and whole dx for this integral. Now we know that the integration of secant square x is 10x. The derivative of x is 1. The integration of secant square x is 10x dx. So Now 1 into 10x become 10x and the integration of 10x is minus log cos x, or you can write down log secant x also. So this is our answer, x 10x plus log cos x plus c. Please note down. Next question number 13 is integration of tan inverse x dx. So students, you can see that we are having only one inverse function. So for our convenience, we'll take one with this just to make the product of two functions, because only then we will be able to apply integration by parts. So inverse function is going to be first function and this one is going to be second function. Apply the formula of integration by parts, first function as it is, integration of second function into derivative of first function into integration of second function dx. So now tan inverse x, the integration of 1 is x, the derivative of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square, and the integration of 1 is x dx. So it becomes x tan inverse x minus integration of x upon 1 plus x square dx. So now we have to think in our mind how to find out the integration. So just see, this is the function and this is the derivative. Already you have done in exercise 7.1, 7.2. So just put 1 plus x square is equal to t. So 2x dx is equal to dt. So that means x dx is equal to half of dt. In substituting this value, we get x tan inverse x minus half integration. X dx is dt. Half we have already taken outside. And 1 plus x square we have taken t. So the integration of 1 by t with respect to t is going to be log t. So log t plus c. Finally the answer is x tan inverse x minus half log. The value of t is 1 plus x square. So it is log 1 plus x square plus c. Please note down. Let's see question number 14, that is integration of x into log x whole square. So students, again integrating by parts. First of all, identifying the first function, logarithm function is taken to be first function and algebraic function to be taken second function. So apply the formula, first function as it is into integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function. So we'll take the derivative and integration of second function whole dx. Fine. This is the formula to find out the integration by parts. Now the integration of x is x square by 2. This is just the sign of multiplication. And the derivative of log x whole square is 2 log x. Just as the derivative of x square is 2x, in the same way the derivative of x log x whole square is 2 log x. And don't forget to apply the chain rule. So we'll apply the derivative of log x also. The derivative of log x is 1 by x. The integration of x is x square by 2 dx. So in the next step, let's see what does it become. X square log x square by 2 minus this 2 can be cancelled by 2 and this x can be cancelled by x. So we get x log x dx. Again, we can observe here that this is actually the product of two functions. So again, in this question, we have to apply integration by parts. So again integrating by parts. So applying the islet, this log x is going to be first function and this x is going to be second function. So see here, x square log x whole square upon 2 minus first function, that is log x, same as it is, integration of second minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function whole dx, bracket close. So now just apply the formula and you get the answer, x square log x whole square upon 2 minus log x into the integration of x is going to be x square by 2 minus integration, the derivative of log x is going to be 1 by x and the integration of x is going to be x square by 2 dx. So see here, x square log of x whole square by 2 minus just open this bracket, minus x square log x by 2 minus minus will become plus and 1 by 2 is a constant, so better to take it outside, and x will be cancelled by x, so we get only x dx. So the final answer is x square log x whole square upon 2 minus x square log x by 2 plus integration of x is x square by 2, so 2 into 2 become 4, so x square by 4 plus c. You can do one step more. You can either take the LCM of these two terms. 2 will be taken as LCM, and you can take x square common, log x common. So inside you will get, this is the optional part, you can do x square log x common. Then in the bracket we will get log x minus 1 plus 1 by 4 x square plus c. Please note down. So students, next is question number 15, integration of x square plus 1 into log x dx. So integration by parts, again this log x is going to be first function by using the rule of Euler, and this is algebraic function complete, so it can be taken as second function. Applying the rule of integration by part, first function as it is into integration of second function minus derivative of first function into integration of second function dx and whole dx for this integral. So the integration of x square is going to be x cube by 3. The one integration of 1 is x. The derivative of log x is going to be 1 by x, and same the integration of x square is x cube by 3 plus x dx. So now log x into x cube by 3 plus x minus, just split this integral, 1 by 3 is a constant, so better to take it outside. X will be cancelled by x cube, so we get only x square dx. Minus plus becomes minus, and x will be cancelled by x, so we only left over with 1 dx. So students, the final answer is log x into x cube by 3 plus x minus, the integration of x square is x cube by 3. 3 into 3 becomes 9. So it becomes x cube by 9 minus x plus c. Please note down. So students, before proceeding to the next question, that is question number 16, I will tell you some important trick that we are going to follow in the next question. Actually, when you will do the next question, it is of the type e raised to power x fx plus f dash x. So the answer is always e raised to power x fx plus c. So students, many times this type of formula will come for the MCQ question, that is for one mark question. You have to just think in your mind what is the function. Just apply, find out the function and multiply by e raised to power x. The answer is going to be e raised to power x fx plus c. Let's see how. I will just give a brief introduction how this is going to be this. So see here, if I will split this integral into two parts, I will get e raised to power fx dx plus integration of e raised to power x f dash x dx. Actually, I am here just proving this integral, how the answer is going to be e raised to power x fx. So here, please remember one thing, that we are having two integrals, but we will not solve both the integrals. We will solve only one integral which is having only function. We will not integrate this function which carries derivative. So we will do integration by parts. Integration by parts says that whatever the function may be, exponential function is always going to be in the last. So that means it is taken to be first function and this is going to be second function. Integrating by parts, only first integral, we get first function as it is, integration of second function minus derivative of first function into integration of second function whole dx plus this integral as it is. I told you that you don't need to integrate this function, just take it as it is. The integration of e raised to power x is e raised to power x fx minus integration f dash x. Integration of e raised to power x is same e raised to power x dx plus integration of e raised to power x f dash x dx. So here you observe that these both integrals are same. One is negative, one is positive. So both will be cancelled. So final answer is e raised to power x fx plus c. Please note down. So students, I hope that you have understood the trick which I have told you, that whenever we are having the integral in the form e raised to power x, fx plus f dash x, the direct answer is going to be e raised to power x fx. So you know that the fx is sin x and the derivative of sin x is cos x. No need to just solve the integral, you can directly write down the answer. Answer is going to be e raised to power x fx, that is e raised to power x sin x plus c. So this question will come in the one mark question only. It will not take a carry 4 mark. So let's see how to solve this. Although you can just tell the answer within a second, that answer is going to be e raised to power x sin x. This is the answer, but you need to prove it. Then see here how to prove it. I told you the same method here. So following the same manner, this is function and this is derivative. So I told you, please never solve the integral which carries derivative. Only solve the integral which carries function. So we have to integrate this integral by integrating by parts using the rule of Euler. This is trigonometric function, this is exponential function. So as per the rule, this is first function, this is second function. So integrating by parts, we get first function as it is. So first function is sin x, the integration of second function minus derivative of first function into integration of second function whole dx plus same, this integral will remain same. Here you don't need to apply integration by parts because in the next step you know that it is going to be cancelled. As you know, the derivative of sin x is cos x into e raised to power x dx plus integration of e raised to power x cos x dx. Now you can see both the integrals are same, they will be cancelled. So answer is sin x into e raised to power x plus c. Please note down. Students, let's see question number 17, that is integration of x e raised to power x upon 1 plus x whole square. So first of all, you have to think in your mind, whenever we are having e raised to power x function, please think in your mind, can we make this integral in the form of e raised to power x fx plus f dash x? Think in your mind that whether you can solve this integral or you can make this integral in that form. So let's see how I'm going to make this. This x is same and you can add and subtract 1. So it will become like this. In the next part, you can just split this function into two parts, that is x plus 1 upon x plus 1 whole square. This can be written as 1 plus x or x plus 1, same as it is, minus 1 upon x plus 1 whole square e raised to power x dx. Now x plus 1 will be cancelled by x plus 1. So I left over with x plus 1 or 1 plus x, same as it is. Students, hardly matter if you are writing with 1 plus x or x plus 1. Minus 1 upon 1 plus x whole square e raised to power x dx. Now you can see that this is actually the function and this is the derivative. So just split this integral into two parts. So 1 plus x into e raised to power x dx minus integration 1 upon 1 plus x whole square into e raised to power x dx. As you know that this is the function and this is the derivative, so I told you that always you have to solve the integral which carries function. So using the rule of Euler, this is going to be first function and this e raised to power x is going to be second function. So integrating by parts, we get first function as it is, that is 1 upon 1 plus x as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function whole dx minus, this integral will remain same, 1 upon 1 plus x whole square into e raised to power x dx. So this is the thing we have done here. This is the derivative and this is the function. So now solving further, we get is equal to 1 upon 1 plus x into the integration of e raised to power x is e raised to power x. Now what is the derivative of 1 upon 1 plus x? All of you have done, the derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. So in the same way, the derivative of 1 upon 1 plus x is going to be minus 1 upon 1 plus x whole square. But you have to apply the chain rule also, for by using chain rule, if I will take the derivative of 1 plus x, then it is going to be 1. It will not affect. And the integration of e raised to power x is e raised to power x dx minus integration 1 upon 1 plus x whole square into e raised to power x dx. So students, see here, e raised to power x upon 1 plus x, minus minus will become plus, 1 upon 1 plus x whole square e raised to power x dx minus integration 1 upon 1 plus x whole square into e raised to power x dx. So now you can see here that both the integrals are same, cancel. So answer is e raised to power x upon 1 plus x plus c. Please note down. So students, question number 18 is e raised to power x 1 plus sine x upon 1 plus cos x. So students, I told you that whenever we are having the function in the form of e raised to power x into something, then we have to use in our mind whether we can make this function in the form of e raised to power x fx plus f dash x. So let's see how I am going to make this function in the form. So in this question, we have to apply the formula of the trigonometrical identities that we have done in 11th standard, chapter number 3. The formula of sine x is going to be 2 sine x by 2 cos x by 2. As in 11th standard, you have done the formula of sine 2x is, the formula of sine 2x is 2 sine x cos x. So that means if I will half the angle, so this is going to be sine x is equal to 2 sine x by 2. Cos x by 2. So I have just put here, and similarly 1 plus cos x is 2 cos square x by 2. So this is the formula I have put. Now just split this integral, split this term into two parts, 1 upon 2 cos square x by 2 plus 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2 upon 2 cos square x by 2 dx. Now it can be written as 1 upon cos square becomes secant square x by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 2 will be cancelled by 2, cos x by 2 will be cancelled by 2, and we left over with only 10 x by 2. So now everybody knows that now it has been changed into the form of e raised to power x fx plus f dash x. What is fx? That is 10 x by 2, because the derivative of 10 x is by 2 is secant square x by 2, and by using the chain rule, the derivative of x by 2 is 1 by 2. So simply you can see here that 1 is function and 1 is its derivative. So always we have to split this integral into two parts after that, and we have to solve only that function or that integral which carries function. So this integral I am not going to solve. This integral I am going to solve by using integration by parts. This is first function and this is second function. So integrating by parts, see this integral I am not going to change anything, because I know that further it will be cancelled. Apply the rule of integration by parts, which says, states that first function same as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function, that is derivative of 10x by 2, into integration of second function, that is e raised to power x dx into dx. This is the derivative. Now just apply the formula and you get the answer. So first integral is as it is, e raised to power x into half of secant square x by 2 dx plus 10x by 2 into integration of e raised to power x will remain same, e raised to power x minus integration. The derivative of 10x by 2 is secant square x by 2. And by using chain rule, we will differentiate x by 2 also. So the derivative of x is 1, so it becomes 1 by 2 into e raised to power x dx. So here students, you will observe that both these integrals are same, so it will be cancelled. C e raised to power x into half into secant square x by 2, e raised to power x into x half into secant square x by 2. So answer is 10x by 2 into e raised to power x plus c. Please note down. So students, next is question number 19, which is e raised to power x 1 by x minus 1 by x square. So students, you can see already this is in the form of fx plus f dash x. No need to time waste your time. Directly split this integral into two parts and you will get the answer. So obviously the derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. No need to solve this integral. Integrating this integral by using integration by parts. So 1 by x is going to be first function and this is going to be second function. So integration by parts, first function as it is into integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function. And this integral will remain same, that is e raised to power x into 1 by x square dx. So the integration of e raised to power x is e raised to power x. The integration of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. So you can either take minus minus as plus. The integration of e raised to power x is e raised to power x. So students, here you observe both the integrals are same. One is positive, one is negative. Cancel. Answer is 1 by x e raised to power x plus c. Please note down. So students, question number 20 I have done because this is same as we have done in the previous question. We have to just make the function and its derivative. Same question is 19 you have done just before. So following the same method, we are having x minus 1 in the denominator. So split this x minus 3 into two parts, that is x minus 1 minus 2. Now split this term into two parts, x minus 1 upon x minus 1 whole cube minus 2 upon x minus 1 whole cube into e raised to power x dx. One factor will be cancelled, minus 2 upon x minus 1 whole cube into e raised to power x. Now you can see that this is function, this is its derivative. So split this integral into two parts. Now we have to just integrate the function which carries only the function and the derivative part will not integrate. So by using Eilert rule, we state that exponential function is always last function. So this function will be taken as second function and this function will be taken as first function. So using the rule of integration by parts, first function same as it is, integration of e raised to power x, that is second function, minus integration derivative of first function, that is derivative of 1 upon x minus 1 whole square, into integration of second function and whole dx, 1 dx is for this integral also, minus 2 upon x minus 1 whole cube into e raised to power x dx. Now the integration of e raised to power x is same, that is e raised to power x minus, as you know that the integration of 1 upon x square is minus 2 upon x cube. It is minus 2 upon x cube. So same here, in place of x, I am having x minus 1. So 1 upon x minus 1 whole square is going to be minus 2 upon x minus 1 whole cube. Sorry. Also, don't forget to apply the chain rule here. I will differentiate x minus 1 also. So the derivative of x minus 1 with respect to x will become 1. So it is not going to affect. Into integration of e raised to power x is e raised to power x minus this integral same as it is. In the next step, you know that negative negative become positive and both the integrals are same but are of opposite side, so they will be cancelled. Final answer is 1 upon x minus 1 whole square e raised to power x plus c. So this is the answer. Please note down. So students, next is question number 21 and this is very important question. Actually, this question comes in the 4 marks. So please try to understand this question very carefully. This function is not in the form of e raised to power x fx plus f dash x. And you can't make it also in that form. So how to solve this integral? Just apply first of all integration by parts using the rule of Eilert. Trigonometric function is going to be first function and exponential function is going to be second function. So integration by parts. First of all, take this integral as I. You can take every integral in the form of I. Now, first function is same as it is into integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function dx whole dx. Now, sin x into the integration of e raised to power 2x becomes e raised to power 2x upon 2. Because the coefficient of x is here 2, so it will come in the denominator. Now the derivative of sin x is cos x. And the integration of e raised to power 2x, same e raised to power 2x upon 2 dx. Now students, in the next step, you will see it becomes 2 is a constant, so better to take it outside. It will become 1 upon 2 integration of cos x into e raised to power 2x dx. So students, here you can see that we are not able to solve this integral. So what we have to do, we have to again integration by parts. So again integrating by parts by using the rule of Euler. So trigonometric function first, exponential function second function. So again integration by parts, again integrating by parts, what do we get? It is sine x into e raised to power 2x upon 2 minus half bracket start. So first function as it is into integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function and whole dx bracket close. So finally it is a sine x into e raised to power 2x upon 2 minus half. Now the integration of e raised to power 2x is going to be e raised to power 2x upon 2 minus the derivative of cos x is minus sine x into e raised to power 2x upon 2 dx. So students, one thing you can observe in this question, whenever we are having the integral which carries one exponential function and one trigonometric function, just remember one thing, always we have to do the integration by parts two times. Because again you can see these two functions will never eliminate, because you know that if you will integrate or differentiate a trigonometric function, the answer is going to be a trigonometric function. And same for the exponential function, integration as well as differentiation both will give the answer in the form of exponential function. So they will not eliminate. How to solve this question? First of all, mark this equation as 1. Now let's see the next part. All this thing is going to be equal to I because we are solving the integral I. So I is equal to sine x into e raised to power 2x upon 2 minus, just open this bracket, 2 into 2 becomes 4. So 1 by 4 e raised to cos x into e raised to power 2x minus minus will become plus, plus minus will become minus. So 2 into 2 becomes 4. 1 by 4 integration of sine x into e raised to power 2x dx. So students, one thing you can observe here that again you get the integral which is not solved at all. But if you will just observe this, this is actually the same function which you are having in the starting. Same function. See, sine x into e raised to power 2x dx. Sine x into e raised to power 2x dx. So we will replace the value by using equation number 1, students. So see here how I am going to do this. This is actually complete I. And you can write down the reason using equation 1. So here I put the value of this integral is equal to I, because this integral is equal to I have taken in the starting. So now just shift this term containing I in the left hand side. It will become plus 1 by 4i. And for both this term you can take better LCM. 4 can be taken as LCM. So it becomes 2 sine x into e raised to power 2x minus cos x into e raised to power 2x. And of course all the integration has been solved. So we can take the constant of integration C. So 1 plus 1 by 4 becomes 5 by 4 I is equal to both. In both the term you can see that e raised to power 2x can be taken common. So inside you get 2 sine x minus cos x upon 4 plus C. Now students, you can observe that 4 can be cancelled by 4. So I is equal to this 5 will be shifted to here. This can be taken as C1. 5 can be taken here. So e raised to power 2x upon 5, 2 sine x minus cos x. And students, just remember I have shifted this 5 in here also. So it becomes c1 upon 5. Now c1 upon 5 is a constant, so we can take again a new constant c. So this is answer, please note down. So student, this is question number 22, that is integration of sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square. First of all, observe here that this is sine burst function, so that means we can put the substitution here to make it simplified form. Just put x is equal to tan theta, so dx becomes secant square theta d theta. Now replace this value in the given function, we get 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, and the value of dx is secant square theta d theta. Why I have substituted the value of x is equal to tan theta? Now you can understand. It is actually the formula of sine 2 theta. In 11th class, you have learned this formula. Sine 2 theta is equal to 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. So for the simplification, that's why I put x is equal to tan theta. Now cancel sine inverse by sine. 2 is the constant, so we can take it outside. So it is left over with theta secant square theta. So now it is in very simplified form. Using the rule of Euler, theta is going to be first function and trigonometric is going to be second function. So integrating by parts, what do we get? 2 into first function is going to be same as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function and whole d theta. So students, in the next step, let's see theta into the integration of secant square theta is tan theta, minus the derivative of theta with respect to theta is 1, and the integration of secant square theta is tan theta d theta. So it will become theta tan theta minus the integration of tan theta is minus log cos theta or log secant theta. I am using the formula log secant theta. I will tell you further why I am not using log cos theta. Now students, in the next step, see here. Why I have used here the formula of tan theta is equal to log secant theta? Because you know that the substitution which you have done, that is in the form of tan. And you can easily convert secant in the form of tan, because in 10th standard you have done the formula secant square theta minus tangent square theta is equal to 1. So here you get the value of secant theta is equal to 1 up square root of 1 plus tan square theta. So see how simple to just change this secant theta in the form of tan theta. Now you can easily put the value. The value of theta from here is going to be tan inverse x, and the value of tan theta is x. So finally it becomes x tan inverse x plus minus log square root of 1 plus tan theta is x. So it becomes x square plus c. So students, further we can simplify it to x tan inverse x minus 2 log. This is in the form of square root, so we can take 1 plus x square whole raised to power 1 by 2 plus c. Now it is in the form of log m raised to power n, so can be written as m log n. So 2 into this m will come in the multiplication using the formula of log m raised to power n, that is m log n plus c. So 2 will be cancelled by 2. So the answer is 2x tan inverse x minus log 1 plus x square plus c. Please note down. So students, next two questions are multiple choice questions. This is question number 23, that is integration of x square into e raised to power x cube dx. So although you can see that this is the multiplication of two parts, don't try to apply this integration by parts, because this will give the answer in a very lengthy form. One thing you can observe, that x cube, see here, if I will take x cube is equal to t, so that means differentiating I get 3x square is equal to dt. So here I will get x square dx is equal to 1 by 3 dt. Yes, we are having x square dx in the question now. So just put the value of x square dx is equal to 1 by 3 e raised to power x cube is t dt. Now everybody knows that the integration of e raised to power t dt remains same. that is 1/3 e raised to power 3. Finally, put the value of e, that is e raised to power x cube. So this is actually option A. So option A is correct answer. Please note down. So students, next is question number 24, that is e raised to power x secant x into 1 plus 10x. First of all, just multiply this. Secant x into 1 becomes secant x, and secant x into 10x becomes secant x 10x. So students, here you observe that this is actually in the form of e raised to power x fx plus f dash x. I have discussed this form, and as this is MCQ question, so we don't need to solve this question fully as per the method. We'll just apply the formula. The answer is e raised to power x fx plus c. So here fx is secant x, because the derivative of secant x is secant x 10x. So answer is e raised to power x secant x plus c. So answer is option B. Please note down, this is option B. So students, here in this video I have discussed all the tricks, shortcuts, formulas, and what are the things that you have to keep in your mind while you are solving these questions. So that will help, definitely help you in your board exam. So I hope so that you will like my video and you have understood all the questions that we have discussed here of exercise 7.6. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much for watching Alicia Maths Classes.